I'm Marc Taylor, and this is live from Studio A, Inside Tracks. We're very privileged to have with us one of our previous Studio A performers, Hammond B3 organist, Caesar Frazier. Good morning, and thanks for joining us.
Good morning, Marc. It's my absolute pleasure.
And I wanted to talk to you about the song that is playing in the background. It's called King of Leonne. Tell me about this song.
King of Leonne.
Yes.
Well, you know, I was designing what I refer to when I'm doing an album project. I consider it as designing a project because I try to look for all of the right elements and the elements that hopefully fit together. So anyway, I needed a song. I needed a different kind of song than some of the other songs that I had lined up. And I happened to have been walking through the house, but I know that in the back of my head and my subconscious, things are always brewing all the time. Anyway, so all of a sudden, this intro came to my mind. Well, actually, I do most of my work actually on the piano, not on the organ, when I'm writing, even when I'm preparing to play, that means exercise. So anyway, I took that idea, and I sit there and I expanded on it, and all of a sudden it started coming together and the chord progressions kind of chromatically, and all of a sudden I had a song, but I had no name for it. So anyway, someplace around, I stumbled into the word Leonne, King of Leonne, but it really represented no real place. It was just fictitious, but I thought Leonne kind of fit and gave it an air of mystery. And it has worked fine because sometimes when I perform live, I open up the show with it. It's like opening, ba-ba-ba-da.
Because the king is coming out.
Well, I'm not a king, so to speak, but at least, you know, it opens up the audience because the song you start with is really important. Anytime you write a song, and if it's worth anything, you're fortunate.
Right.
Because it's not easy to do. And sometimes it takes you years to finish one song. Sometimes you finish a song in 5 minutes. King of Leonne didn't take me years. It took me maybe a day or two to put it all together. However, I'm designing two projects with a longtime dear friend of mine, Houston person. I happened to mention to him that I was going to San Francisco to record. So he says, well, why are you going way out there? He says, why don't you come back home to New York to record? And we made him talk another minute, and I said, well, what are you saying? Are you wanting to produce a record with me? He said, well, yeah, that's what I was saying. That's what I do. So anyway, then I'm going back to a studio that I haven't recorded in a long time, Rudy Van Gelder's in Bergenfield, New Jersey.
Beautiful.
And that's where I'm going to record a project with Houston Person.
Okay.
Last year, I haven't had a dull moment. It's been all trying to figure out how to play better and understand the language of jazz. Jazz is a language, and understand how it, and you never finish in your life understanding the language. So that's what, then in my future, I'm hoping that a more finite understanding of that language will be able to transfer to the music in the studio that's coming up.
I want to say thanks to Caesar Frazier and thanks to each and every one of you for joining us from live from Studio A Inside Tracks. I'm your host, Marc Taylor, and thanks for joining us.